हेलो,
आर यू एबल टू हियर मी सर? डायरेक्शन मिलन सर,
हाँ यस मैडम,
यस यस मैम,
वॉइस
यस
इज
मैम,
वेरी
बट
फीबल.
देर इज अ लिटिल लैग. यस मैम,
पार्डन
देर
मी
इज अ
सर,
लिटिल लैग.
हियर देर इज नो इंटरनेट कनेक्शन इन द कॉलेज. इट्स द प्रॉब्लम.
There is a little lag in the voice.
So I'm managing with the mobile data.
Okay.
That's why the problem is. Shall we start, sir? Only 53 participants now. Shall we wait for 2 more minutes or start,
Yes,
sir?
ma'am. They are coming on, ma'am. They are keep on coming. It is reason. Okay, ma'am.
For 2 minutes, shall we wait?
Yes, ma'am, we can wait now.
குட் மார்னிங் சார். வேல்முருகன் சார்,
குட் மார்னிங் மேடம்.
ஹவ் ஆர் யூ சார்?
ஃபைன் மேடம்.
ஓகே, ஆர் யூ ஸ்டார்டட் ஒர்க்கிங்
ஹலோ.
சார்?
ஆ
ஆர்
மேடம்,
யூ ரிப்போர்ட்டிங் டு ஆஃபீஸ் ஆர் யூ ஆர் ஒர்க்கிங் ஃப்ரம் ஹோம் சார்?
ஐ அம் ஒர்க்கிங் ஃப்ரம் ஹோம் மேடம். ஆக்சுவலி
ஓகே
நவ
ஓகே,
இட்ஸ் குவாரண்டைன், லாக்டவுன்.
குவாரண்டைன் இஸ் நாட் இட் கம்ப்ளீட்டட். ஓகே,
நாட் இட் கம்ப்ளீட்டட். இட் ஐ திங்க் இட் It will take more than 2 months.
Okay, okay, sir. Today is the last day of the seminar.
Ah, yes, madam.
And it's the closing with artificial intelligence printing.
But I will. May I start, madam, now? Shall I wait for a few
we
more?
Will start. A few more minutes shall we wait, sir? Let it be 100, I was thinking like that.
Okay,
because
madam.
Every day 200 are reporting.
Oh, okay. We'll wait, madam. No problem.
So only 50%, if it comes, it will be easy for us. Another 50% before the formal starting of the presentation, another 50% will join, I think, sir.
Okay, madam.
You will be covering the 3D printing and artificial intelligence, sir.
Artificial intelligence, madam.
Artificial intelligence, what and all in constructions it will cover, sir?
Ah, yes, madam. Artificial intelligence and the brief introduction of construction industry.
Okay, 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 sir. Are you having any projects regarding this, sir, in your office?
No, madam. Just.
Just I want. No, because
the just collected the information.
Internship. If they have any project, we can ask them to work on internship on those projects to know further.
Not yet, madam. Not yet started that one.
Okay.
Just have some knowledge about that.
Okay, sir. Because this cloud computing, artificial intelligence, big data, all these things are alien to the civil engineers.
It's an emerging topic,
so
madam,
scared,
right now.
Yeah, and they are so scared and they won't touch even the staff. They don't want
but
to
it is,
touch it.
But it is very simple as other engineering. The thing is, we have to apply that.
Definitely, sir. Definitely. Only until it is unknown, it will be useless. Once it is known, Dayachandran sir, shall we start?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. We can start, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Because slowly they are coming inside. Shall we start? We have waited for another
4 minutes.
Now I hope we will
start. Yes, ma'am. We can start, ma'am.
Good morning to all the participants and good morning to our chief guest, Engineer Velmurugan Ramalingam.
Good morning, sir. I once again welcome
all the participants in this webinar series for the last day, that is 7th day of this webinar series. Today we are going to cover about artificial intelligence and 3D printing. As sir was rightly pointing out, this artificial intelligence and using big data, cloud technology, all these words are new to us, but the application only in the civil engineering field. So we should know the applications of all these technologies, which is very vital for the academia, that is the teaching as well as the students, teachers as well as the students. The teachers, once it is getting updated, they can better equipped and can guide projects in this regard. And that is what the future of civil engineering is. I hope this will be yet another interesting session where you will be using the advanced technologies and application in the civil engineering field. Again, I welcome Engineer Velmurugan Ramalingam and all the participants. I now request Dayachan.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, to introduce our chief guest. Dayachan, please.
Yes. Good evening to all. As we are at the end of our series, that is, we are in the day of our 7-day webinar series. All this day, we have tremendous support from our Aishwarya Engineering College management, faculty, students, and our participants who are giving continuous support for the last 7 days. Nearly 11 sessions we have finished. All the 200 participants were giving a lot of support to us. Today we are having a very nice session and a new session on artificial intelligence. Everybody knows the word artificial intelligence, but we doesn't know how the civil engineers and how the infrastructure development can able to correlate with this artificial intelligence is a new thing for us. I think our speaker, Mr. Velmurugan sir, will be giving a lot of speech. And I want to introduce our Velmurugan sir. He finished his MS Structural Engineering in IIT Madras, and he had 4 to 5 years of field experience in this technology, as well as he worked in Bangalore, he worked in a lot of other places also. He had a teaching experience also, nearly 10 years he had it. Now he is doing a teaching facility and a training programs to the people and the students in Benchmark Academy. I welcome our chief guest speaker, Mr. Velmurugan sir, for this nice occasion. And I think this session will be a very informative and a useful session, as previously we had it. So I warmly welcome our Velmurugan sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the introduction. Hi, everyone. Good morning. It's a pleasure to be here with you all. Let me introduce myself. I am Velmurugan, a civil engineer, teaching faculty in Benchmark Academy. I thank Dr. S. Lavanya Prabha, Head of Civil Engineering Department, Aishwarya Engineering College, for organizing a webinar series on advanced technologies in infrastructure development. And I thank coordinators, Assistant Professor M. Jyothi Lakshmi and Assistant Professor K. S. Dayachandran, for inviting me to present a webinar. As you see on screen, our discussion is about a fantasy topic which is happening, trending, emerging, and making revolution in industry. Yes, it is artificial intelligence, and we are going to see its application in our civil engineering industry. So we have constructed buildings, cities, and built skyscrapers, tunneled through mountains, redirected rivers, constructed roads, power lines, made airplanes and satellites, and now we are aiming to conquer the solar system. It took us several million years to reach this point, but the progress has started since the first industrial revolution, mechanization in 18th century, driven by the invention of steam engine. Second revolution, mass production in 19th century, driven by the invention of electricity. Third revolution, automation in 20th century, driven by the invention of electronics and information technology. And we are living in the fourth revolution, socio-economic transformation, driven by artificial intelligence. So what is artificial intelligence and how is it making industrial revolution is the discussion here. Let me start with the definition of intelligence. It is something related to mental capability of brain. So intelligence can be defined in many ways: capacity for logic, understanding, self-awareness, learning, emotional knowledge, reasoning, planning, creativity, critical thinking, and problem solving, etc. Intelligence of living beings like plants, birds, animals, and humans may be called as natural intelligence. And intelligence of non-living things can be called as machines, may be called as artificial intelligence. So how do we define intelligence of your plant? Have a look at this plant. It is touch me not plant or sensitive plant, Mimosa arboricola plant, displaying its unique folding reflex, it is closing its leaves when someone is touching it. It is experimented by Monica Gagliano on sensitive plant. Repeatedly dropping a plant from 6-inch height and observed its behavior. Plant was curling its leaves due to fear, such that someone is attacking it. Maybe it is called as defensive curl. After few drops, dropping few times, plant stops curling of leaves. It understood that there is nothing to fear. So Monica Gagliano, she reported that it is nothing but evidence of remembering. So plant can remember. She presented this one to another other scientists, but they said that it is not remembrance, it is loss of energy. They assumed that the curling of leaves is a work, so it lost its energy, so it cannot close its leaves even more. Now see, did other tests like shaking test, different type of test on the same plant. She noticed that the plants were closing its leaves now. That means it didn't lose its energy, it is having some energy. And again she did the dropping test after 7 days, that is 7th day and 28th day. She observed that the plant was not closing its leaves. That means plant can remember. And it has a long-term memory. It is the intelligence of this plant. Maybe different plants can have different type of intelligence. I'm just talking here about this sensitive plant. And now coming to intelligence of birds. So see here. So bird is dropping stone to raise the water level to take its food. Here the bird is playing with rings. Here bird playing with toys. Bird following following traffic signal. Now here intelligence of animals. Monkey is cracking nuts using some tool, and cat is opening a bottle. So please have a look. It's a cheetah jumping and walking over the bridge to cross a river. So these are all some kind of intelligence by naturally it got from it has intelligence of it is called living beings. And coming to humans, because through this intelligence he has making revolution in earth through his intelligence. His achievements are communication, writing a language, mathematics, logics, science and technology, agriculture and domestication of animals, medicine, printed books, computer, internet, social media, concepts of human rights and democracy, space travel and exploration. He achieved many things. These are very few. Now, coming to our topic, main topic, intelligence of machines, which is artificial intelligence. This is a machine or a computer with some data. These are data already fed to this computer. If I ask the machine to identify this object, it will say this one is apple. Because the data already there. If I ask this one, it will say banana. And if I ask this one, identify this one, the machine cannot identify this object. It struggles. The input data is not matching with the data in this machine. Now consider another machine, intelligent machine with the same data. It identifies the object as banana, even though the input data is not exactly matching with the data in this machine. It can identify the object. So what is it? This is nothing but artificial intelligence. So intelligence of this machine to identify an object even though it doesn't have the data about that object. By comparing these two, the intelligent machine having artificial intelligence. First one is having intelligence, some kind of intelligence, but the second one is called as artificial intelligence. So what is artificial intelligence? Is it a magic or science or is it technology? What is your guess? So artificial intelligence is a science that uses technology to create magic. So now you might have got some idea about artificial intelligence. So living beings got intelligence from nature, but how machines got intelligence? Machines got intelligence artificially from human. So human wanted to improve speed and efficiency in all his work. So he planned to create a machine with intelligence for his assistants. So consider a human and a computer, maybe called as machine or computer. Let us assume a machine which is showing human intelligence like learning, thinking and making decisions. Learning, thinking and making decisions. So this is how artificial intelligence came into existence. So human wanted some assistance from machines. So he created machines with artificial intelligence. So artificial intelligence is a field of computer science that deals with creation of machine that can work and react like humans. If we consider artificial intelligence as an idea, then machine learning and deep learning are the subsets of it. We can say in another way that machine learning and deep learning are methods to achieve artificial intelligence. Now let's see what is machine learning is. Machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence where we teach machines how to take decision with the help of input data. So we will understand machine learning with this little example. So what do you see over here? It is a bird. And what about this? It is a bird. And this? It is again a bird. So how do you know all of these are birds? You have been taught by your teacher or your parents that this is a bird, and your brain learned that anything looks like this, looks like that, is a bird. And that is how brain functions. Education and training. But what about your machine? Now, if I ask machine to identify this object, will it be able to identify it as a bird? So this is where machine learning comes in. So what we will do is take all these pictures as a data and feed them to this machine until it learns all the features associated with it. Once it learns, that means education and training. Once it learns, I'll give a new data to determine how well it has learned. That means testing of machine. So by briefly, we can say that training and testing of machine is the underlying concept of machine learning. So machine learning is categorized into supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforced learning. Let's start with supervised learning. Here, machine is trained using data and tested with new data. If the data is matching with the already available data in the machine, it will identify it. Otherwise, it will say some error. So for this case, a fingerprint analysis is an example for this one. Once record trained machine with the fingerprint data, from next time onwards, when you put fingerprint on machine, this machine will scan all of its user data, and if the machine finds the match of your fingerprint with its data, then your fingerprint will be verified. Now, see what is unsupervised learning. Here, the input data does not have any label. We didn't mention anything like it is apple, it is orange, it is banana, something like that. But the machine automatically groups the data based on similar pattern, that is clustering. By identifying the similar patterns, it has grouped it. It is grouping it. Example, recommendation by YouTube. Whenever you see some video on YouTube or Netflix, or internet browsing, the recommendation suggested by YouTube or Netflix are some examples for unsupervised learning. Now, coming to reinforcement learning, this algorithm revolves around punishments, and its ultimate aim is to achieve more rewards. Consider an example of self-driving car. This car has to reach its destination without hitting barricade. Here, car takes an action and hits the barricade and gets punishment. So the car realizes that hitting barricade will give punishment. And from next time onwards, car goes in correct path and gets rewarded. So this process continues and car learns how to drive by itself without hitting any barricade. So this type of learning is called as learning from mistakes, called as reinforcement learning. So now coming to deep learning of artificial intelligence. Deep learning is a subset of machine learning, where we develop intelligent algorithms which mimic human brains. Our brain primarily consists of composed of neurons. Neuron can send and receive electrochemical signals. So it is brain human. Left side is human brain, right side mimic of human brain, artificial brain. So we have a neuron over here. The electrochemical signals received from dendrite are processed in cell body, and output is sent to other neurons and axons. So our task is to create an artificial neural network that mimics biological neural network. So artificial neural network of artificial brain comprises an input layer, hidden layers, and output layer. Input received from input layer are processed in hidden layers, and output is received in output layer. It is somehow related to human brain process. The hidden layer has many layers. depends upon the kind of problems, kind of situation occurring. It will do many processes and finally it gives output some kind of output as an answer, as a solution, like human beings. So limitation of machine learning here is, so features of the object, suppose consider this as an object, the features of this object has to be manually extracted and fit to this machine. And the machine learning algorithm then gives the result as it has elephant. But in deep learning algorithm, automatically extract the features from object and gives the result as elephant. It is the difference. What is the difference between machine learning and deep learning? Machine learning had to give manual feature extraction, and here it will automatically extract the features and classify it and give output what it is. So now you might have been learned and understood that the science behind the magic, artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning. So machine learning extracts the feature of the object through deep learning, and artificial neural network gives weightage to the features according to the data available to find all the possible outputs hidden in layer. Finally, predicts the object as banana. Technology is machine learning, artificial neural network algorithms in deep learning. So this is just a small example. I have just mentioned it, but this is not a story like only for fruits. It is just a simple introduction. Artificial intelligence application in industry is very huge. It can do many magic like this. That's not a magic, but science behind the magic. It has many sciences behind the artificial intelligence. So artificial intelligence and levels of learning. So artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning. So capacity of a machine to imitate intelligent human behavior. So machine learning is the ability to automatically learn and improve the learning from experience. Deep learning, it is mimic of human brain. Maybe it is the artificial neural network. Okay, artificial intelligence needs contribution from computer science, psychology, neuron science, biology, philosophy, maths, sociology. Even more, it needs contribution from various other departments. That means it needs more knowledge to solve the problems. The knowledge can be from any divisions. Some of the important tools and techniques of artificial intelligence are listed here. Knowledge-based expert system, artificial neural network, genetic algorithm, fuzzy logic, particle swarm optimization, ant colony optimization, search optimization, probabilistic methods for uncertain reasoning. So I am going to discuss only few of these tools. So first, a knowledge-based expert system. It is an expert system which comprises knowledge base and inference engine. So facts and knowledge from experts are collected and utilized in inference engine to give an expert solution, expertise solutions to the users. So KBES is based on this concept. So artificial neural network, so already we have seen that it is a mimic of human brain and giving weightage to the problems based on its importance. So ANN is the ability to learn or recall or generalize the problems from training patterns or data, maybe numeric or non-numeric or maybe both. It's ability to recall, ability to regeneralize. Genetic algorithm mimics the natural behavior evolution process, biological and social behavior of species. Genetic algorithm provides optimum solution where the mathematical search techniques may fail. The survival of the fittest is utilized in optimization of the genetic algorithm. Now coming to fuzzy logic. Fuzzy logic is an approach to computing based on degrees of truth rather than true or false. Maybe from this by comparing with Boolean logic, we can understand what is fuzzy logic. In Boolean logic, whether it is true or false, whether the answer is 0 or 1. But in fuzzy logic, here the answer is from 0 to 1. How much sort? The value will vary from 0 to 1. In on-colony optimization, it is based on behavior of ant and its teamwork. So why do ants walk in a line? Every ant is following the shortest path by proper communication and teamwork. So here, let's take an example. The ant has to take food. It is somewhere away from the nest. So it will make trial and find many trials, and finally it comes to conclusion to find the shortest path between the nest and the location of food. This can be done by teamwork. So how to go? It is the teamwork done with the other ants. That is, the ant colony optimization is also same thing, like mimic the behavior of real ants, like ants living in colonies that communicate with each other using pheromones in order to accomplish complex tasks such as establishing a shortest path from nest to food sources. Maybe we can utilize this concept in environmental engineering, design of sewage path to find the shortest path. That is, identification of shortest path to sewage treatment plants, something like that. So coming to data science. So till now we have studied about discussed about artificial intelligence. So artificial intelligence is an idea. So where, what is the necessity of artificial intelligence? Because I have a problem. I have many problems. Suppose finance problems, banking sectors, education institutions, and construction industries, health industry. They have many problems. They need somebody to solve that problem. Even human can solve that problem, but it takes more time. So they need assistance from machine. So machines can do the work, only it will follow our instructions. But one thing is, it has to make decisions automatically. It has to give some idea, give some assistance for humans. That idea is called artificial intelligence. But to apply this concept to our field, we need data. What is happening? What is the problem here? That means the data, to apply this artificial intelligence, we need data. So data can be acquired from machine data, organization data, people data. So machine data can be acquired from smart devices like cell phones, smart watches, and many other equipments, and medical equipments, and some sensors. And organization data, finance, bank, and in bank institutions, hospitals, HR departments, retail stores, and some, you can say many other organizations like colleges, schools, offices. People data from Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and among all above other data, the data is huge. Everyone is using Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter now. So if you count the data, it is very huge. By studying this data, we can come to many conclusions about social behavior of humans. So who will study this data? The data will be studied. If you study all this data, it takes studying all the data by human is impossible. So we need artificial intelligence. That's why we implemented it. Here, we have data. By giving proper context to the data, we'll get some information. And if you give meaning to the information, you'll get some knowledge. And giving insight into the knowledge, we'll come to conclusion. That is wisdom. Let us take an example. That is, data collected by our cell phones gives information like time and location gives information that from 10 p.m. to 6 a.m. he is in location A and 7 a.m. to 2 p.m. he is in location B. And giving meaning to that information, it finds that location A is home and location B is work. And analyzing that one, it is giving direction to us that it is time to home, it is time to work. This is a simple example of a data information knowledge system. Data, how data is converted into knowledge, it is from converted into information, and it is a knowledge and wisdom. The whole process of artificial intelligence, if you are, is we can take this one as example. So artificial application intelligence application in every industry, something like
your voice is breaking, so that we can. Hello, yes, sir. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Hello. Hi, sir. Yes, sir.
Sir, can you hear me? Your voice is breaking, sir. We cannot hear properly.
Breaking,
your voice is breaking, sir. So that we cannot hear
wait,
properly.
Sir, I'll check it.
Yes.
Is it okay, sir? Hello.
Yeah, I know it's a little bit clear, sir.
Oh, okay.
Yes, sir. Now it is little bit.
So clear. Okay, sir, if you have a problem, just intimate me, sir. I will just take it. Okay, I will proceed. Thyssen Group, it is an.
Yes.
Thyssen
sir,
Group,
yes, sir.
It is an elevated. There is an escalator company, maybe lift and escalator. Can replace the parts before they wear out by predictive maintenance. And the journalist robot preparing news, weather report, stock exchange, sports news, many. And the application of artificial intelligence in astronomy. Recently, NASA and Google has announced that two more exoplanets called Kepler-80G, Kepler-90I. Tesla, autonomous car driven by artificial intelligence. Voice virtual assistant, Siri in Apple, Google Assistant in Google Pixel, Cortana in Microsoft, Bixby in Samsung, and Magic Live in Huawei. There are many applications. And one more thing, if you imagine one, customer relations can be maintained by chatbots. And in medical field, cancer detection by Google Deep Learning and IBM Watson is much faster than normal doctors. So application of artificial intelligence in many other fields are banking sectors and retail and distribution, home assistant like Alexa, and art. It is the art, a picture of Rembrandt. He was a famous artist, that is painter. His drawings are there, but we don't have his painting, that means his own image. So what artificial intelligence did is, it collected all the pictures of other painters, other artists, and finally it has decided and come to the conclusion that it is the picture of that famous artist called Rembrandt. But we don't know whether it is correct or not, but it has come to the conclusion that it is the picture of Rembrandt. And coming to this latest one, humanoid robot, world's first robot citizen in the citizen of Saudi Arabia. If you see, all the industries now started to using this artificial intelligence. The industries are healthcare, transport, agriculture, education, e-commerce, entertainment, robotics, automotive, social media, data security, finance, gaming, astronomy, everywhere. They're all already using this artificial intelligence, whether they know or don't know about this one, but they are already using this intelligence. Now, coming to our industry, civil engineering. So the civil engineering industry is using this idea called artificial intelligence. Yes, we are also using it. Already we started to apply in fields like structural engineering, geotechnical engineering, environmental engineering, groundwater and hydrology, survey, transportation and construction industry. So I am going to discuss only very brief introduction to these applications. Just see this one. It is structural engineering optimization. In analysis and design, artificial neural network can predict or select the most suitable structural system for high-rise buildings subjected to wind and seismic loads. By embedding sensors in components of structure, can help the monitoring of structural health by artificial intelligence. We cannot monitor the structure for the whole day and the whole time, but by using artificial intelligence and the sensor, it will take care of us. It will guide us how to. It will guide the data. So new material, maybe strength and properties of high performance concrete and high strength steel can be predicted accurately by artificial neural network. Maybe we can study the nonlinear behavior of materials. Many materials are there. Only linear material is. I think only mild steel only will showing the linear behavior, but all other materials are showing mostly nonlinear behavior. We can get some clear idea about those things by using artificial neural networks algorithms. And in geotechnical engineering, always called as maybe mining engineering, problems like stability of slopes and strengthening of soil can be improved by applying artificial intelligence. Many other problems like bearing capacity, settlement of pile foundation and shallow foundation, seismic liquefaction potential of soil, stability of soil slope and rock slope, pull out capacity of ground anchor, rock engineering, geo environment connectivity problems, site characterization, earth retaining structure, uplift capacity of suction caisson, soil properties such as over consolidation ratio, compression index, undrained shear strength. There are many problems in each department. This can be assisted by artificial intelligence. And here, coming to environmental engineering, pollution. Pollution is a major problem of our environment. So have a look at this video. This is the current situation of current environmental thing happening around us. Around few months back, the whole environment was polluted by many things. But now, only advantage we got from quarantine is lockdown is COVID is environment cleaning. Maybe the pollution has reduced a lot. In this video we have seen a sentence like drinking water from Ganges. I don't know whether it is correct or whether it is true or not. That much clearance within 1 or 2 months, our environment has got cleaned, getting cleaning day by day. So these kind of real-time problems can be monitored by real-time air quality monitoring systems and analyze what is happening in the environment. This can be assisted by artificial intelligence by monitoring the whole environment around us. And water and sewage treatment plant can be maintained by predictive maintenance. And have a look at this. These are all study based on our satellite images. This can be done by the analysis of data regarding groundwater and many other problems can be done, be analyzed and improved by using application of artificial intelligence. And some other problems in hydrology can also be solved by, can be assisted by artificial intelligence, like rainfall forecasting, runoff prediction, reservoir operation, stream flow prediction, estimation of evapotranspiration, drought analysis, soil water storage, flood routing, modern drainage pattern. These are all the problems we are going to face in near future, maybe in water. Main thing is groundwater. So soil water storage, everything can be monitored by application of artificial intelligence and can be using some predictions like artificial neural network, genetic algorithm and fuzzy logic. But you need data. The data from, if you see the development of artificial intelligence, it took 20 million, not 20 million, maybe some, it was up to fourth revolution. If you see the first, second and third revolution, it took initial gap of around 100 years. But artificial intelligence, after third revolution, it took only 50 years to become artificial intelligence. And now, every 10 years, some revolution will occur, something like that. It is. Our development is very fast now. Anything can happen in positive way or in a negative way. But you have to change everything into positive of human beings by studying and analyzing the environment, groundwater, hydrology, many things behind us, around us. So coming to transportation and surveying. Now everything is become modernized due to 3G, 5G, 2G sensors, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and everything is getting modernized. I think 5G is coming now. So even transportation becoming automatic cars, everything is changing. So according to that, the transport systems should also get modernized. Should modernize. See, there are so many cars traveling, traffic analysis, and according to the traffic data, the traffic volume, we have to construct the road and pavement, many things are there, and signals. We have to change according to the development around us. So transportation should improve to accommodate smart traffic systems. So systems should accommodate automatic driving vehicle. Maintaining payments, forecasting future traffic volumes, speed and travel times, traffic signal timing and pacing controls, control of public transportation, driver perception of safe separation of vehicles and stopping distance, overtaking distance, many things are there. And vehicle design, passenger comfort. Passenger comfort is the major necessity, philosophy of transportation engineering. On highway capacity analysis and level of service determination, And the main advantage of artificial intelligence in our industry is the construction industry. Please have a look at this video and you will get some clear idea and thought about what is artificial intelligence, how it is helping in our construction industry. Some idea about what is artificial intelligence, how it is helping our industry. Artificial intelligence, to apply this concept to our industry, we need data. If we have data, it will assist us to make a real time real time decisions and many improvements like cost reduction, safety in the construction industry, and materials using utilizing the materials, about laborers, construction contractors, many things it will assist, like assessing the construction site clearly. We have to assess the construction site in each and every department, making access to data. Data is the most important one in construction industry. Safety and risk management, cost controlling, automating the building planning and scheduling, automating machines. There's machines also controlled by artificial intelligence, like trucks and lorries, and digging materials and excavating materials, excavating machines. So let's take this example, human. Currently, all the buildings are constructed by humans without any artificial intelligence, but in future, it will help to come out with a very accuracy higher than humans. So humans cannot store all the data. He is having memory power, but that is very less compared to humans. If you ask what is 2 into 2, we can say 4. If I ask what is 16 into 4, 64, we can say. But if I ask you what is 1350 into 2368, something like I ask, you cannot answer this. We cannot answer. As a humans, we can calculate, we can solve the problems, but it takes more time to solve that. That's why we have the application of artificial intelligence coming into picture. So here, data, he cannot maintain this much data. And here data is missing, data is falling down without his knowledge. So to overcome this thing, we have to upload the data, everything, we have to convert the data, everything into soft copy. This data, once you give the input to the system, it will be distributed to all the engineers in the site and the project managers. Everybody can checklist it. What is happening inside? And it is playing major role in safety or risk management in a construction site. It is intimating the engineer. He is having some instrument in his like watch, in his smart watch. It is intimating the engineer that there is some electric shock is there in his path. That kind of intelligence it is giving to us in construction industry. And reduction in cost. This is a major and most important problem. He is a senior most engineer, and something happens to him, he is released or retires from that company. His knowledge, what happens? It makes a huge vacant, huge impact on the construction company, because his experience and knowledge cannot be transferred to any engineers within short duration. It will make huge loss for the company, because his experience is the most important thing we need in construction industry. So to overcome this one, the application of AI. While he's moving from the out of the company, he will transfer. He can leave just as it is. The new engineers can come. If the new engineer know artificial intelligence, he's having the knowledge of artificial intelligence. He can directly take that project and proceed without any delay in the project, without causing any impact causing any loss in the project. So here comes the tool that is building information modeling, BIM. So above all, what I have told about you about the application of artificial intelligence in construction industry is managed by a software called BIM. Building information modeling. It is a 3D model software used to plan, design, construct, manage efficiently from the planning of building to demolition of the building. It can maintain all the data. Planning, designing, building, and operating. That is data from planning to demolition. It will maintain the data. When we can utilize the data, but who will operate those data? Who will maintain those data? Who will study those data? That's where the role of artificial intelligence is coming here. So 3D information model can be drawn by using, prepared by using BIM. When we apply time to the 3D model, 3D become 4D BIM. That is the project scheduling. We make 3D model into 4D model. And when we apply cost to the 4D model, it become 5D model. So that is BIM software yields so much of information, 3D, 4D, 5D, everything is there, data is there. But using this data, human experts struggle to get the most out of it. But artificial intelligence, to make use of this information, make the process a lot more effective. Please have a look on this software called BIM. First one is, it is a drawing which is having a civil engineering drawing, architectural drawing, electrical drawing, plumbing, so many. There is multidisciplinary collaboration between engineers and architectures for better insight to work more efficiently and study about energy consumption before construction itself. And 3D visual, live 3D visuals can be seen through before construction itself. Retain model intelligence like automatic construction documentation, minimizing the errors, and reducing coordination issues between engineers. And owner satisfaction is must. So he is very happy with that. Very few errors, optimized design, better understanding, and reduction of cost, improved schedule. So project owner will be very happy. And future operation maintenance. Once you handle the project, once you handle complete the construction work, and we will give the, that means we will transfer it to, we will give it to the owners. So while operating, while using the building, he has to maintain that building. So even that is also possible in this software. There is predictive maintenance, asset tracking, and facilities management. Even this asset tracking is monitored by this software called BIM. But this is not possible in building information modeling without the application of artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is a real-time application. It has to be updated each and every second. That needs internet. That means connections in connection between the world. Everyone is connected with the data. That is the major disadvantage of artificial intelligence. That is the data, personal data. Everything is hacked by some others. The major disadvantage of artificial intelligence. But there should be some security behind that one. So coming to BIM. Sensors, mobile devices, virtual reality, augmented reality. We have seen in the video drones and virtual reality, augmented reality, and so many things. Everything can be used to replace the construction industry with the help of artificial intelligence. So now coming to the question, we have seen till now, we have discussed about this topic, artificial intelligence. The situation, if you see the situation here, is artificial intelligence going to be a job killer for humans? Yes, surely this will happen, because it is doing automatic jobs in every industry. So in each already industries are losing their jobs. That is in the negative point of view. That means 20 million manufacturing jobs worldwide will be lost. Because our manufacturing is done automatically by machines. But if you think positively, automation will displace jobs, but it will generate many new jobs. The kind of jobs we don't know, but it is going to create new kind of jobs based on artificial intelligence. It is more than the jobs which is reducing, that is displacing jobs. So the idea is here. We need new type of education to develop the necessary knowledge to manage the artificial to manage and learn and understand the artificial intelligence. Otherwise, something like inequality, the people who know artificial intelligence will be learning more, and something like inequality, right? And inequality in the industry itself will happen. So the education should be given to all to develop necessary knowledge to understand artificial understanding, to how to apply that to our industry. And one more question here is a major one, and that is war between artificial intelligence and human intelligence. Whether it will happen, it is thought by Elon Musk, the Tesla founder, and Stephen Hawking. They have mentioned that maybe in near future, there will be a war between artificial intelligence and human intelligence. If that happens, Who will be the winner? Maybe this can happen. Maybe this also can happen. Maybe both will become friends, or maybe we will become toys for the artificial intelligence. They will operate us. Now we are operating the artificial intelligence. In future, it can happen. They will operate us. They will treat us like a toys. They can. So this can happen. But what is my opinion is, not my opinion, it's maybe it's the theory, true sign of intelligence is not knowledge, it's imagination. So till now we have seen that artificial intelligence is not the intelligence. Learning, thinking and decision making is not intelligence. Only imagination is the intelligence. The human has the power, imagination power. With that power, we can overcome any problems, and even if a war happens also we can win the situation. And coming to our hero's quote, that is dream, dream, dream. Dreams transform into thoughts and thoughts result in action. It is the quote by our hero, Abdul Kalam, sir. His thoughts can be taken as imagine, imagine, imagine. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for a valuable lecture in this artificial intelligence. And you have deeply explained about how the artificial intelligence will work and how it will analyze the data. And you have briefly explained the various fields of civil engineering, how the artificial intelligence is being used nowadays, and how will be the future. And I think this lecture is very, very informative for the newcomers, that is the new civil engineers, as well as for the new faculties who are coming as a teacher. I think this session is very, very nice. I open to our participants that if they are having any doubt, they may ask, kindly give some answer.
Thank you, sir.
Participants, if you have any doubts, you can ask our speaker. A few questions are available in the comment section. Shall I ask you, sir?
Yeah. Okay.
How the water resources and the water pollution can be...
Sir, noise is this.
How the... Yes, sir, I can hear you. Yeah, I can hear you. Shall I ask the question? How the water resources and water pollution can be handled or analyzed by this artificial intelligence?
Actually, artificial intelligence is, I told you, this is not a magic. It is a science. So we have to utilize that science by giving proper information, proper data to that intelligence, and it will give the possibilities. It won't create magic that the water, it won't give water, it won't give something. It will give only solutions, possibilities only. We have to come to conclusion that how to manage water resources. And right now we are facing a water scarcity problem. Maybe we have to improve the groundwater and surface water by building dams, many dams, and construct lakes, ponds. We have to do it. Many people are telling me that infiltration, soil infiltration, by constructing house rainwater harvesting system will help. Maybe I agree with that one. Even having a rainwater harvesting system in home, we have to construct a lake or pond in every village or cities. The storing of water in a large huge amount of water in a place will improve the groundwater level. By I can say that only the water from house cannot go deeply into the groundwater level. It cannot reach up to the groundwater level. You have to store huge amount of water in a place. That means building a you have to construct a large dam. Not dam. You have to construct some like a structure like pond or lake in every villages. It will improve the groundwater level. And we can give those data to monitor by artificial intelligence.
Yes, sir. One more question from Gokul Krishnan. If there is any small error in software programming in artificial intelligence, will it affect the construction? How to overcome it?
Yes, actually, we have to train and test. The machine learning and deep learning is there. We have to train and test the machine. If it is a problem already happened, surely it won't happen again. That means it is having the capacity to correct the mistakes. But if it is happening, something new incident, it will, some error will be there. We have to, there is some risk is there in artificial intelligence. You have to agree with that one. Hello, sir.
Okay, sir.
We can proceed.
Yes, sir. One more question, sir. Whether any company or construction field or any infrastructure companies are using this artificial intelligence in India for their construction of buildings?
All kind of type of MNC companies are using it, like BIM software and artificial intelligence, they are using it. I cannot mention particularly about any company, but all are slightly imposing it now, trying to modernize it. Like Indian company don't have a clear idea, but there are somehow they are implementing it now.
Sir, one more question. I think this is the last question from the participants.
Okay, sir.
What is the difference between augmented reality and virtual reality?
Virtual reality, it is something like already we have seen movies, something like wearing glasses, 3D movie, three-dimensional movie. There is virtual reality, something technical. This question is something technical. It will help us in construction industry analyzing without computer. Without carrying any instrument with us, just taking a small instrument, we can see the drawings and analyze the data by using the virtual reality. This question is somehow technique, but I just go through this and I'll let you know after this session through mail.
Okay, sir. Fine. Thank you, sir. Thank you for a valuable session, sir. By allotting more than 1.5 hours in this session, you have given a very nice knowledge sharing presentation, sir. Thank you. On behalf of our Ishwari Engineering College and the Department of Civil Engineering, I want to thank Speaker Vel Murugan, sir, for this session.
I have to thank specially Jyothilakshmi Madam for inviting me this for seminar. Thank you, Madam.
Thank you, sir. Velmurugan, sir. Thank you very much. And Dr.
Thank you,
Madam. Thank you very much, sir, for all of that covering up in this area. And I hope this enjoyed by the participants. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Participants, in the feedback form, there is an error. There is no option in the typing the name so that you can fill your name in feedback so that in capital letters will be identifying your name. So kindly bear this mistake.